Hi, my name is Sareena, and I'm an engineer who breaks down the science of hair care so you can learn more about your hair and the products you use. And today we're reviewing the K18 Damage Shield line. We have a shampoo and a conditioner. This is not sponsored at all, so we're going to break down the ingredients of the products and then see how well it performs. Now let's get started. This product line from K18 is not only meant to repair your hair, but it's also meant to protect your hair. And this is important because your hair goes through so many different types of stresses. From going outside, styling your hair, brushing your hair, combing your hair, using heat tools, and using chemical treatments, your hair goes through so much damage. So you need to be using products that's going to protect and repair your hair. Before we go into K18, we have to know a little bit about strength and repairing products that are currently on the market. So I'm going to put this on the side. A lot of products that are on the market that strengthen and repair your hair only do so on the cuticle, which is the outside layer of your hair. This is because they have conditioning ingredients that can sit outside the cuticle, which does a great job at protecting the hair, but doesn't necessarily repair the internal structure of your hair. What makes K18 different from other products is that they have K18 Peptide. The K18 Peptide is able to go into the layers of your hair, all the way to the cortex, which is the second layer of your hair, where the keratin chains that make up your hair reside. When your hair goes through damage, especially when it's chemical damage, the keratin chains in your hair can be broken. But luckily, the K18 Peptide can actually bond to those broken keratin chains. Now, keratin chains are really, really important to your hair's shape, structure, and strength. So when they're broken, your hair is more weak. And with the K18 Peptide repairing the keratin chains in your hair, you're making your hair stronger from the inside out. Now that we talked about how the K18 Peptide works, let's talk about the shampoo. The first ingredient is a solvent, which helps other cosmetic ingredients dissolve in the formulation. The next ingredient is super important, especially when it comes to shampoos. They're called surfactants. Surfactants are cleansing agents that clean your hair and scalp. The next ingredient, of course, is the K18 Peptide, which we know repairs your hair from the inside out. The next ingredients are going to help hydrate your hair and help it keep it moisturized. And then to finish up the ingredient list, we have preservatives, fragrances, and product stabilizers. These ingredients make sure that the product stays safe to use over time, that they smell nice, and that the product performs at the level it's supposed to perform. Next, we have the Damage Shield conditioner. First ingredient, like the shampoo, is a solvent which helps dissolve cosmetic ingredients. Next are our emollients, which form a protective layer around your hair to make it easier to detangle, make your hair more moisturized, to soften your hair, to make it shiny. These ingredients, for the most part, are going to stay on the outside of your hair, which isn't a bad thing because they help do all those great things like protect your hair. Next, we have humectants, which help retain and attract moisture from the surrounding environment and improve the product's texture. And of course, since this is a conditioner, we're going to have an emulsifier, which help water and oil-based ingredients mix. Next are conditioning agents, which are going to help you detangle your hair, make your hair more manageable, make it shiny, and really soft. They also sit on the outside layer of your hair, like emollients. And of course, next we have the K18 Peptide, which repairs your hair from the inside out. And the rest of these are antioxidants, product stabilizers, preservatives, and fragrances. They're going to make sure your product smells nice, protect your hair from UV rays, make sure the product is stable and safe to use. There's two ingredients that we didn't go over. Ultraminous ferment extract, which is derived from marine bacteria to protect your hair from hard water. Ceramide MP, which helps restore the lipids that surround your hair. This helps seal, protect, and smooth your hair, specifically where it's damaged the most. It's able to do this because your hair naturally has a negative charge, and when it's damaged, it has even more negative charge. And Ceramide MP has a positive charge, so it's able to find those damaged sites in your hair and smooth it out and help protect it. Now that we know what to expect from the products based off of the ingredients, let's see how well the products perform. For the routine, I will first go in with the K18 Damage Shield Shampoo. Then we'll be using the K18 Damage Shield Conditioner. And instead of rinsing out conditioners, I like to use conditioners as leave-in. So we're going to be using this conditioner as a conditioner and leave-in. And then we're going to be following up with the Not Your Mother's Curl Talk Gel. Now let's try the products.
Are you coming in or out?
This is the culprit.
First, we're starting off with the Damage Shield Shampoo. It has a really nice consistency that I can tell it's going to lather very well in the hair. And lather means it's just going to be very bubbly. And I could see it working well for someone who has an oily scalp or oily hair. I got this little scalp brush from K18, and so I'm going to use it to help get an even better clean on my scalp. One downside of using a shampoo that doesn't have a lot of conditioning agents, it makes my hair very tangled. I prefer using a conditioning shampoo on my hair because it's curly and my hair is also bleached, because otherwise it gets very knotted like you see here. I'm hoping that the Damage Shield conditioner can help a bit with this, so let's try it out. I did struggle a little bit actually getting the conditioner out of the bottle for some reason, but I started applying the conditioner from my ends to my roots, and at this point I was a little worried that it was going to be difficult to detangle. But I have high hopes for K18, so I let it sit for 2 minutes before I started detangling. After the 2 minutes, my hair was more manageable, and I started finger combing because I feel like finger combing is the best test to see how well a conditioner is going to help you with detangling your hair. But because my hair was so tangled from shampooing and also my hair being dry, I decided to use a detangling brush instead of finger combing. It took roughly 8 minutes to detangle my hair with my detangling brush. It probably would have took about twice the amount of time if I had finger combed. I like to use conditioners as both conditioners and leave-ins because it makes my hair routine a lot faster and allows me to use less amount of products. And whenever you're using a conditioner as a conditioner and leave-in, you want to make sure you put the conditioner on your hair, detangle, and then you have to wet your hair a little bit because your hair starts to dry. And when you start styling, your hair should almost feel like seaweed. And at that point, that's when you know you can add your gel. And I'm using Not Your Mother's Curl Talk Gel to style my hair. You want to make sure you're using a lot of gel because this is what is gonna actually hold your curls. I wash my hair every 2 to 3 days, so I want my curls to actually stay nice for those 2 to 3 days. So using more gel will help with that. At this point, my hair is soaking wet, so before I plop my hair with the aqueous flip, I like to scrunch my hair a little bit with a microfiber hair towel. I really like this microfiber hair towel because it's really soft and it's also huge, so whenever I have my wash days, it's super helpful. After I finish scrunching my hair to get a little bit more of the excess water, I then plop my hair with the aqueous flip. And I'd either let my hair dry or I'll diffuse after 20 minutes of wearing the aqueous flip. Okay, now we're good to go. Here's my hair and my scalp before using Damage Shield. And yes, this is a microscopic image of my scalp. You'll see it has a lot of buildup and has some dry places. And this is after. So the shampoo does have a very effective cleanse. My scalp did feel a little tight from shampooing, so I definitely follow up with a conditioning wash whenever I use this shampoo. My hair isn't too frizzy, it's very shiny, and I have a lot of curls forming that I haven't seen in such a long time. And this is all due to Damage.
Whenever they create products, I always look forward to trying it because they always create innovative products. From the use of biometric polysaccharides like the marine bacteria that helps protect our hair from water, to using smart lipid technology to find damage sites in our hair, these formulations from K18 are not designed just to sell you another product, but to develop with a deep understanding of hair, which isn't something you see with a lot of hair care companies. So I'd highly recommend adding the Damage Shield to your routine because I'll definitely be using it in mine. I hope you found today's deep dive into the science behind K18 is helpful for your hair care journey. As an engineer, I'm super passionate about learning and then teaching you about your hair so that you can learn more about your hair and the products you use to make your hair care journey better. I'm Sareena, and if you enjoyed this breakdown and review, be sure to subscribe for more insights into the world of beauty and hair science. Don't forget to follow me on TikTok at Sareena Karim and Instagram at FollowQHair. This is Sareena, helping you understand the science behind your hair. I can't wait to see what we learn next.